Us fasting for the sake of Allah and remembering our brothers and sisters in Palestine. It's reminding ourselves that oppression in one area is an oppression to all of us. We are one ummah, one body. They're hurting right now, so we're not feeling any better about ourselves. Tonight the Quran will be recited in the heart of New York City and in the heart of the world, where over like almost a million people pass by daily. So we want the Quran to be heard by millions of people, not only over here, but across the globe, and let the people's hearts and ears turn back to Allah, their creator.
My name is Faisal Latif, and I'm from Tampa, Florida. So Tarawih in Times Square 2024, we did it in 2022, we did it in 2023, and every year it's the same thing. The effort is a da'wah effort. Da'wah means to show people what Islam really is, right? So when we do the prayer, we'll have the translation up on the projector so that people can realize what the Quran says. And it's just, it's an outreach effort. Essentially, it's showing others what Islam really is. It's showing people that Muslims are not what you think they are, that Muslims are your brothers and sisters in faith, you get what I'm saying? So that's about it, alhamdulillah. All praise to God. You know, we started off small, and each year it's been getting bigger. This year they've given us the most space that we've had so far. So that's what Tarawih in Times Square 2024 is to bring Muslims together on the first night of Ramadan, celebrate it together, and more importantly, show, you know, the hottest spot in New York, what Ramadan and what Islam is.
But why is it in Times Square?
It's a melting pot. Times Square, you see people from all different places, all different ethnicities. You got a lot of tourists, and it's the place where that it could have potentially the highest impact. You know, we could do it in Central Park. We could do it elsewhere, but nowhere gets more attention like this. You know, and so the goal is diversity. The goal is having a diverse impact, and a diverse outreach for what the effort in itself is. When I started, I was really young. My parents put me into it at a really young age, but it wasn't until like 15, 16, where people started, you know, complimenting my voice, whatever have you. And from that point onwards, it was just, you know, building it. And the attention isn't always good. You know, it caters to your ego, arrogance, pride. So it's been a journey just combating that. Especially when you're doing something that involves spirituality, you know, it's greater than you, and that's what's beautiful about it. The voice aspect teaches everywhere, you know, like there's so many people around the world who have phenomenal, beautiful, amazing voices, and just grateful to be one of them, you know, who gets to call the call to prayer, who get to lead the prayer. It's truly an honor and blessing that I obviously can't fathom or understand, but it's a responsibility that I'm glad that, you know, God has given me the honor and the blessing to do. He could have chosen anybody else to be here tonight and the other years that this has happened, and I'm grateful to Allah, I'm grateful to God that He has chosen me to be here again tonight. It's the sincerity. You know, a lot of the times people recognize you for your voice, or they'll say, you know, we like your voice, or we like your call to prayer, but we forget what it actually is. It's a call to prayer. So I'm doing something that is calling people to that which pleases God most, prayer, you know? So it's important to be sincere. So the hardest part is to make sure my heart is in check. Honestly, that's it, yeah. Yes, I would like to say that free Palestine. I would say stop the genocide in Gaza. Free Palestine, free the brothers and sisters in Palestine. Stop starving them, stop occupying them, stop oppressing them. They're our brothers and sisters, and they need to be treated like human beings, not like something less than that, anything less than that. And our brothers and those in Israel need to understand that. That's it.
سمي الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
Starting a prayer very, very soon to start coming in the times. Clear the area so people can come and see. Remember, this is a da'wah event. We want the world to see what the Quran is. We want to explain to them that the holy month of Ramadan is starting. The month of Ramadan is here. The holy month of Ramadan is here. We will be fasting for 30 days and 30 nights, inshallah, in which the Quran, the last and final revelation given to mankind, will be recited. From memory, we've memorized our book. Our book will never get lost. It will never get changed. It will never get altered. Alhamdulillah, say alhamdulillah. It will never get changed or altered, my brothers and sisters. Never. This book will be recited for 30 straight days from memory, cover to cover. Tonight we'll be reciting the Quran as well, inshallah. So we will be having some Quran recitation just to start it up. The vibe, inshallah, before Maghrib Salah, which will be happening in just a little bit. Inshallah, recite
that. Said Ali, it's right here behind you. Behind you.
Yo, get somebody
outside of his
table, bro. He's not there right now.
Bibi,
I've already told you.
Bro,
it's just temporary. It's just temporary.
The ayat of Ramadan, right? We're not, alhamdulillah, we'll be in the state of Ramadan, in the month of Ramadan, I should say, in only an hour. Right? The month. That the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, is Mubarak, right? So inshaAllah khair, we'll be studying the ayat in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that he has revealed this Quran. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم شهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. In these ayahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that this month of Ramadan, it is the month that the Quran was revealed. Right? That's the whole point of it. Why is Ramadan so blessed to us? Right? Why is Ramadan so blessed? Why is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the best of the prophets? Why is Angel Jibril the best of the angels? It's all due to the Quran. The Quran, whatever it touches, it becomes Mubarak, blessed, the best. Right? Jibril, he was sent down with the Quran to teach the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so he became the best of the prophets. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was the prophet who got the Quran, which the Quran was revealed upon to, and he became the best of the prophets. Right? And the month of Ramadan, it is the best month. Why? It is the month that the Quran was revealed in. Now, we'll do a little Q&A session, inshallah khair. Was Ramadan the month that the whole of the Quran was revealed? Or was it a month, was it the month that the first ayat, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق, was revealed? Who can answer? Who knows the answer? Or who can try to answer? Anyone? Was the month of Ramadan the month that the first ayat of the Quran was revealed? Or rather, was it the month that the whole Quran was revealed? Sunnah, تفضل.
First ayat? That's what many of us would think, right? But no.
The month of Ramadan, it is the night in which the whole of the Quran was revealed. Right? And when was it revealed? We say Laylatul Qadr, right? The night of Qadr. That's when the Quran, the whole of the Quran, was revealed down from Allah Azza wa Jal down to the lowest heaven. The whole of the Quran, kullaha. Right? Good guess though. A lot of us, we tend to think either or. So, alhamdulillah, we got that cleared out that the whole of the Quran was revealed in this month of Ramadan. inshallah khair. Now, let's have a little exercise, inshallah khair. Who would like to come up and start reciting Quran? Whatever you'd like. We'll do ayah for ayah. Any, let's choose juz amma. The 30th juz, if anyone would like to come up, inshallah khair, come up and just start reciting from a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. Any ayahs from juz amma, and we'll go from ayah for ayah, or you can kamilha, you can finish it, inshallah khair. Bismillah. Anyone brave enough? Anyone? Bismillah, tafaddal. Whatever you like.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
الله يبارك فيك، جزاك الله خير. تكبير، الله أكبر. بسم الله. Now that the ayahs you recited, right? Surah Al-Ikhlas, one of the shortest surahs. Not the shortest, but one of the surahs. Inshallah khair, تفضل.
Surah Al-Qadr. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربك من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر.
Now the first ayah is Surah Al-Ikhlas. Especially during the last 10 nights when we believe any of them might be Laylatul Qadr.
Find a seat because I don't want you to be walking
around
this area. I see
you
walk over.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث.
تكبير تكبير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Ramadan Mubarak. Ramadan Mubarak. This is a month of blessings, a month of devotion to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isn't it amazing that we can gather in this cold weather? We don't have no form of violence, no form of aggression, but we're here as Muslims. Allahu Akbar, takbir! And we're here in this cold, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know the hadith, when there's a gathering remembering Allah, the angels descend and they find that gathering until they pile up one by one to the heavens and report this same gathering to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah commands the inhabitants of Jannah, of paradise, to remember us by name. Takbir! And they make dua for us until the ending of this gathering. And what better night than the first night of Ramadan to have a gathering of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Takbir! Can I get a mashallah? Can I get a mashallah? Alhamdulillah, Allahumma barik. Thank you guys for coming out. We're filling out spaces, inshallah. Sisters, may Allah protect the sisters who have, you know, security, inshallah. Make sure they're safe. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. We're gonna have some people. Okay. Can we get the camera crew to make space for the projector? You wanna have a projector place right here, inshallah, please. Camera crew, you can find any other place. Thank you very much. We're gonna have the projectors here. The purpose of Ramadan. Who knows the purpose of Ramadan? The purpose of Ramadan. Who's gonna grab the mic? Bismillah. purpose of Ramadan.
I think the purpose of Ramadan is to feel how poor people feel.
Can I get a mashallah? To feel how poor people feel. The subhanAllah, is that it? Is to feel hunger? Is it a month of hunger? No, it's not a month of hunger.
Ask for forgiveness for all our sins.
Forgiveness, mashallah, mashallah.
To praise Allah, subhanAllah.
To praise Allah, of course.
To cleanse yourself of your bad habits and get closer to the deen.
We all need that tune-up. You know, some of us have cars that haven't been tuned up in like 20 years. But we get a tune-up once a month. And this is the month to get that spiritual tune-up. It's not just a month of abstaining from food. The Prophet ﷺ said, for those who lie, those who have aggression during the time of fasting, he's just hungry. There's no spiritual effects or benefits from fasting. He's just hungry. And we don't want to just be hungry, because we can be hungry today, yesterday, and next year, whatever. We can be being hungry. It is a factor. But it's tuning up your actions, protecting your tongue from harming others, protecting your hands from harming others, abstaining from that which Allah has made haram. Even the water and drink and food that is halal for us, we have to abstain from that as well. So it's about self-discipline, self-restraint, and it's about taqwa. Kutiba alaykum siyam, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Allah has written or prescribed fasting for us so that we may gain piety. That is the true purpose of our fast, to gain piety, to gain the consciousness of Allah. Allah is always watching. I can't hide in the closet, drink a gallon of water, and say, brother, I'm tired. Oh, mashallah, it's a long day fasting. I can't do this. Fasting is the only deed that is done purely for Allah. It's the only deed, good deed, that's done purely for Allah, because only Allah knows who amongst us are truly fasting. And that doesn't mean truly abstaining from food, but abstaining from harming others with our tongue and with our hands. Islam, we have our qari of tonight, one of our qaris, Brother Faisal, Imam Faisal, Sheikh Faisal, however, and mashallah, he's going to be the qari of tonight. He's going to give a few words, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I know it's cold, but I know you guys got more in you. Come on, say it with your chest. Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah. You know when I say salam, right? Hold on, put my water down. When I say salam, I'm making dua for you. When I say assalamu alaikum, say may Allah's peace and blessings be upon you. Let me get the same energy back. Assalamu alaikum. There we go, alhamdulillah. I felt that one, I appreciate you guys. It's cold, but I felt the warmth of that one, alhamdulillah. Say alhamdulillah one time. Say alhamdulillah another time. Inshallah, tomorrow we're gonna be fasting. Say alhamdulillah if you have no worries for your suhoor. Say alhamdulillah. Say alhamdulillah if you're gonna go home tonight and be safe. Say alhamdulillah. Say alhamdulillah if you're going to be warm in bed tonight. Say alhamdulillah. How many brothers and sisters of ours will not have that around the world? Say alhamdulillah. You know all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you and me? The ability to sit here, the ability to see, think, breathe, hear, any single blessing that you can think of. Every single blessing that you can think of. And on top of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deemed you and I worthy and blessed enough to enter another Ramadan, man. Alhamdulillah. Musa alayhi salam was told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all these blessings that he gives us, you know what is sufficient? Allah says, if a slave of mine just says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, that is sufficient. He has thanked me for my favors upon him. So right now, let's recite together, okay? We're going to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, all right? I'll do one ayah, okay? And you do the next ayah, okay? So I'll do Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You do Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. I do ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, okay? Let's do it. Recite from your heart. Recite solely to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Realize when we recite here right now, Allah is going to be listening to us. Realize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be looking down at us. Recite in a way where Allah tells the angels, He tells Jibreel alayhi salam, "Oh Jibreel, I love those people." Let's be from those right here, right now, tonight, where Allah tells Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, "I love those people." Do we want the love of Allah? Say it like you mean it. Do you want the love of Allah? Bismillah. Here we go. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم. We're gonna do one where we recite after me. But realize one thing. It doesn't matter if we're in Times Square. It doesn't matter if we're in London. It doesn't matter if we're in Africa or inside of a masjid. The earth belongs to who? Say it again. The earth belongs to who? Allah. Allah has deemed you and I. He has brought us here today to recite His words in a place like Times Square. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Anybody else want to do something here? How much do they have to go through? Allah says, my slaves want to honor me. My slaves want to mention me. In the hottest spot in New York, Allah says, let's make it happen. Look at where we are. Allahu Akbar. Takbir. 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 Let's recite Surah Al-Fatiha one more time, okay? I'll say it and you say the same thing back, inshallah, okay? So I say Bismillah, you say Bismillah. I say Alhamdulillah, you say Alhamdulillah, okay? Here we go, Bismillah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Remember, you're reciting for Allah. You're not reciting because I told you to. You're reciting for Allah. Let His words leave your tongue, inshallah, okay? Say it with your chest. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
For those of us gathered around, that verse means all praise is due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. The most merciful, the most compassionate. The most compassionate, the most merciful. Maliki Yawmiddin. Master and owner of the Day of Judgment. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. You alone do we worship. You alone do we seek help from. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم.
اهدنا الصراط المستقيم.
Guide us. Guide us to the straight path. صراط الذين أنعمت. What is that straight path?
Because I think you have
the path of those who have earned your favor. غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Not the path of those who have earned your wrath. And that is the opening chapter of the Quran. جزاكم الله خير. And I'm going to hand it back to my tall brother, my bigger brother, my older brother.
بارك الله فيك. جزاكم الله خير. تكبير. I see a lot of beautiful faces, mashallah. I want to shout out some countries, mashallah, that's here. You know, Islam is not a religion of the Arabs. That's a misconception of Islam.
I'm going to be moving this.
That Islam is only for Arabs. I love my Arab brothers, but Islam is not yours. Islam is for the world. Alameen. All of the worlds. So I want to get a shout out to some countries here. Habibi, salam alaikum.
Salam.
Where are you from?
From Mauritania.
Mauritania. Takbir. MashaAllah. Where are you from, brother?
I'm from Mauritania.
Another Mauritania. Takbir. Two Arab countries, huh? Where are you from, Habibi?
Morocco.
Morocco. Takbir. Habibi, where are you from?
New Jersey, brother.
Jersey town. Takbir.
Okay,
where are you from, Habibi?
France.
France. MashaAllah. Takbir. Habibi, where are you from?
Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Takbir. Oh, I love the energy. It's cold. We got the energy, MashaAllah. Where are you from, Habibi?
India.
India. MashaAllah. Takbir. MashaAllah. Where are you from, Habibi?
Morocco.
Morocco. Takbir. Habibi, where are you from?
Pakistan.
Pakistan. Takbir.
Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Takbir. We're going to pray in 5 minutes, inshallah. The adhan will be made in 5 minutes, right? Inshallah. Habibi, where are you from?
Honduras. Honduras.
Honduras. Takbir. We worldwide, mashallah, we worldwide. Where are you from, Habibi?
I'm from Bangladesh.
Bangladesh. Can you get a big takbir? Where are you from, Habibi?
I'm from Morocco.
Morocco, mashallah, takbir. We're going to work our way around the world, mashallah. We got the world right here. Where are you from, Habibi?
Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistan, takbir. Are you related to Khabib?
Habibi, I'm your brother, don't... Please, salam alaikum, you come in peace, how do you do? Don't hurt me now, you keep resting the beers over there, mashallah.
Takbir!
Where are you from, Habib?
Dominican Republic.
Another DR, Dominican Republic, takbir! Tayamo, peace and be to that, Habib, Tayamo.
See, I learned,
take care, it's like we won, right? That's we won. I gotta get my Spanish, I'm relearning, Habib, where are you from, big shake?
Algeria.
Algeria, takbir! MashaAllah, mashaAllah, we went around. Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. He wants to shout out this country. This is very important. Where are you from, Habibi?
Senegal.
Senegal, takbir!
La ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah. Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mashallah. Can you get a mashallah? We have the world right here. East, West, Asia, everywhere, mashallah. And we come here as brothers. The greatest bond is to love your brother, fi sabilillah. Before we pray, I want to share this hadith with you of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sweetness of Iman. There are three things that you should have if you want to taste the sweetness of faith. One is to love Allah and His Messenger more than anything. More than your money, your wealth, yourself, your family, your friends, your commerce, your business, more than anything you like, your hobbies. You love Allah more than anything, and you love His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, more than anything. That's number one. Step one. Step two is to love your brother and sister. Peace be to Allah. You don't love him because he has a beautiful sister. You need to get close to him. No, brother. You don't love him because he has money and you can benefit from him financially. No, that's not true love.
You don't love him or her because he's famous or she's famous and she can put you on. No, 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 no. You love that person, peace and be Allah. Only for Allah's sake. You love the good in that person. And you want to do good to that person. Number three, the last one, is to hate disbelief as you hate to be thrown in the fire. To hate disbelief. What is disbelief? To cover the truth. To deny the truth. To deny Allah and His signs, His miracles, His books, His angels, His prophets. The day that we meet Him, His decree. One that we should have to have the sweetest of Iman, and wallahi, I don't know you, but I love you, fi sabilillah. I love you for Allah's sake. May Allah accept. Barakallahu feek. It's time for Maghrib.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على
just like hearing it up the good of the Okay, inshallah, in approximately 2 minutes, we will get the salah started. So get nice and close to your brothers and sisters, inshallah. I mean, brothers with the brothers, sisters with the sisters, astaghfirullah. Look at you, I saw someone else smirking. La hawla wa quwwata illa billah. Inshallah, get close, fill in the gaps, make the lines, inshallah. Keep your brother warm, all right? Sorry. Straighten the lines, inshallah. Complete the lines in front of you.
Shoulder to shoulders, foot to foot, heel to heel. Leave no gaps for Shaitan. And make sure the line is straight, brothers. Make sure the line is straight, and make sure the line behind you have space to make ruku and sujood. Bismillah. Touch your brother beside you, shoulder to shoulder. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the best salah is the one who has soft shoulders. So don't be, ain't no charges over here. Just soft shoulders, toe to toe. Sisters lined up. Bismillah. May Allah accept. Is this in the way? Brother Ayub, can you proceed to the front if you can? Brother Ayub in a wheelchair. Brother Ayub, is he fine? Brother Ayub, are you fine, Brother Ayub? Brother Ayub, we want you to come to the front, Habibi. Can you come to the front? Bismillah. Thank you. Brothers, we have Zamzam water for sale as well. This is from the Zamzam boys, alhamdulillah. Also, we have Team Najm is here, mashallah. And we will speak to you about our sponsors, mashallah. Najm Institute, if you look that up on your phones, support them, follow them. It's online Islamic course and they do public da'wah. Najm Institute. May Allah accept. Bismillah.
Brother Luqman, come to the front.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استقيموا يرحمكم الله الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. أياما معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم، ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والضحى والليل إذا سجى، ما ودعك ربك وما قلى، وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى، ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى، ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى، ووجدك ضالا فهدى، ووجدك عائلا فأغنى، فأما
اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث. الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا ولك الحمد.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر
الله أكبر. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم
صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم
غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين. Okay, Ayat al-Kursi. Does everyone know Ayat al-Kursi? Alright, we're going to do this one together. Loud and clear. This ayah tells us who Allah is. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض.
الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه.
يعلم الله أيديهم وما خلفهم
ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه
نشاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. Okay, now we're going to go all the way to the back of the Mus'haf. We're going to keep it simple. Where the kids at? Anybody got any kids out here? Any kids? Surat al-Nas? You ready? Ta'ala, ta'ala. Where you from? Egypt. I knew it. I know it. I'm not Egyptians when I see one.
Takbir.
Agdanes. Minam from Mosul.
Banha.
All the way down. I ain't been there for. I've been to Iskandaria. Okay. اسمك ايه حبيبي؟ احمد. انا اسمي فراد حسن. اوكي سو هنقرا ايه وانت انا ايه وانت ايه. سو ام ريسايت ا فيرس اند هيز غانا ريسايت ا فيرس. اوكي بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل اعوذ برب الناس
ملك الناس.
قربها شويه عشان الناس تسمع.
ملك الناس اله.
أنا واحدة وأنت واحد. أنا واحدة وأنت واحد.
It's okay. Okay. نبدأ
من الأول. Okay. أوكي. أستعملها لوحدك. يلا أحمد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل أعوذ برب الناس
ملك الناس
علي صوتك يا هلا علي صوتك علي صوتك
ملك الناس
إله الناس
من شر الوسواس
الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. Ahmed, just a little shy. It's too many cameras, too many lights. I understand, Habib. Thank you so much.
Takbir!
It's okay. Allahu Akbar. Shukran. It took a lot of courage. I appreciate it. Okay. Now we're going to move on to Surah Al-Falaq. Okay? Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul a'udhu bi Rabbil Falaq. ومن شر غاسق إلى وقب ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. Okay, I'm gonna say that verse one more time. ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. May Allah protect us from the evil eye and those who wish evil upon us. Amin. Say amin.
Amin.
Okay, this surah is all about Tawheed, Surah Al-Ikhlas. Everybody standing here, sitting here should know Surah Al-Ikhlas. And if you don't know, we gotta fix that. Okay? Bismillah. Together, everybody together. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qul huwallahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ.
Again, one more time.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفواً أحد.
قل هو
الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
تكبير.
الله أكبر.
تكبير.
الله أكبر.
Okay, we're gonna move on to سورة المسد. Who knows سورة المسد? You wanna come recite سورة المسد with me? You ready? You sure? Okay, بسم الله.
Come. بسم الله. What's your name?
This is
Aziz.
Aziz.
Where from?
ما شاء الله. Where you from, Aziz?
Uzbekistan.
Uzbekistan. I love my Uzbekistani brothers. So I live in Nashville. And the big community, the big Muslim community out there, yeah, are from Uzbekistan.
Yeah.
Okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب I got you We're gonna do this together. I got you. Repeat after me. Let's do that one more time. ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب تكبير تكبير سيصلى نارا ذات لهب
وامرأته حمالة الحطب
في جيدها حبل من مسد بارك الله بارك الله فيك
We have our brother right here from Algeria. What should we do? What's your name?
Fatih.
Brothers in the back, do you mind sitting? Because your sisters can't
see. Can we make some space over here for my brother, please? So he can.
Okay, we got brother Fatih from Algeria. Okay, our brother from Algeria, brother Fatih, is going to recite 2-3 ayahs for us. Bismillah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته. لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون
الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم صدق الله العظيم
تكبير
الله اكبر
تكبير
الله اكبر
تكبير
الله اكبر
All right, so now we're gonna go ayah for ayah with my brother Faisal right here. Surah Al-A'la. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى
الذي خلق فسوى
والذي قدر فهدى
والذي أخرج المرعى
فجعله غثاء أحوى
سنقرئك فلا تنسى
إلا ما شاء الله
إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى
ونيسرك لليسرى
فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى
سيذكر من يخشى
ويتجنبها الأشقى
الذي يصلى النار الكبرى
ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا
قد أفلح من تزكى
وذكر اسم ربه فصلى
بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا
والآخرة خير وأبقى
إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى
صحف إبراهيم وموسى
الله أكبر I'm going to recite Surah Al-Fajr. It's one of my favorite surahs. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Wal-Fajr.
Wal-Layalin 'Ashr.
Wash-Shafi' wal-Watr.
Wal-Layli idha yasr.
هل في ذلك قسم لذي حجر
ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بعاد
إرم ذات العماد
التي لم يخلق مثلها في البلاد
وثمود الذين جابوا الصخر بالواد
وفرعون ذي الأوتاد
الذين طغوا في البلاد
فأكثروا فيها الفساد
فصب عليهم ربك سوط عذاب
إن ربك لبالمرصاد
فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمن
وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه فيقول ربي أهانن
كلا بل لا تكرمون اليتيم
ولا تحبون على طعام المسكين
وتأكلون التراث أكلا لما
وتحبون المال حبا جما
كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا
وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا
وجيء يومئذ بجهنم
يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى
يقول يا ليتني قدمت أحببت لحياتي.
فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد
ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد.
يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة
ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية.
فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
اللهم أعطينا الجنة.
ليس لوقعتها كاذبة
خافضة رافعة.
إذا رجت الأرض رجا
وبست الجبال بسا
فكانت هباء منبثا.
وكنتم أزواجا ثلاثة
فأصحاب الميمنة ما أصحاب الميمنة.
أصحاب المشأمة ما أصحاب المشأمة.
السابقون السابقون
أولئك المقربون.
Guys, please, if you can move down, move down. I don't want anybody past this point, please.
بارك الله فيك.
Nobody past this
point.
Thank you so much. Please, guys, please, if you can move down. Please, please.
Allahumma Uzbekistani brothers. So I live in Nashville, and the big community, the big Muslim community out there are from Uzbekistan. Okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب.
ما أغنى عنه ماله
إلا حبل من مسد. بارك الله فيك.
What's your name?
French. 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 French.
Brothers in the back, do you mind sitting? Because the sisters can't see. Okay, we got Brother Fethi from Algeria.
Those words were given to Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam, and Allah sent them down to this earth for you and I to be a part of them. Say Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored you and I so much that those words are a part of our life. Say Alhamdulillah. That mushaf at home that we're not too eager to open all the time, Allah's words are in that book. Say Alhamdulillah. And there's nothing more valuable. No words.